Hi, welcome back to the seminar Introduction to Python. In the last seminar we learned about Matplotlib and Pandas. These are two very common modules in Python. And yeah, of course there was some homework. And the first homework was about plotting something. So in the homework from the week before, we already wrote a function to roll the dice, and the output was a set, and now the output should be a list, so just the numbers we rolled. And we do that many times. So the first data point is then the mean of just one dice roll, so the dice roll number itself. And then the mean of the second of two dice rolls and so on. So at the end, yeah, the function or the plot should go to 3.5. Okay. Then we had some Excel sheet where some weather data was included. And you should work with that. So one task was then to plot the mean temperature and add a plot title and so on. So just try out the different plot options. And the third task was then to plot the minimum temperature and the maximum temperature in just one plot and add a legend. Then we wanted to have the difference of the maximum temperature and the minimum temperature. We just defined a new variable and plotted. Then we had to do some subplots with special colors I asked for. And the last question was to find the most rainy day. And yeah, this is also very easy using the max function. And yeah, after finding the maximum value of this rain value or perception value, you want to have the index of this data frame. Today I will discuss some things that belong to the topic functions, but we didn't discuss so far. So we will deal with the keywords in, any, and all, and we will talk about arcs and quarks, and then about lambda functions and maps, and about exceptions. So we will quickly go through all these definitions and do some examples as usual. So let's start. We already know the keyword in, but we didn't use any and all so far. So yeah, let's just start with an example. So we start with in, any, and all. So first about this keyword in. An example would be banana. In, I like to eat apple and banana. And yeah, we can just use it to define Boolean values. So this is true because the substring banana is in the string I like to eat apple and banana. We can also use this not only for strings, but for example for lists. So here I just make a short list of fruits. And now we can ask if n in I like to eat apple and banana for N in foods. So basically I ask if, yeah, for every N in fruits, N is in I like to eat apple and banana. So let's try this. And yeah, it's true, true, and then false, because the lemon is not in this sentence here. Then we come to the next keyword. So if we just want to know if any of the fruits are in this sentence, we can use the keyword any. So yeah, for example, any of these values here is true, because there is at least one true value. If we have this, we get also true, but if all the values are false, yeah, then we get false. Of course, we get also true if all the values inside here are true. And yeah, then we can just use this to ask if any N in I like to eat apple and banana for N in fruits is true. Yeah, and this is true because at least one of the fruits is, yeah, contained in this sentence. Then there's a third keyword I want to introduce here, and this is all, and yeah, probably you guess it. If I have a list of true, false, true, and false, not all values are true, so we get false. But if we just change the false values to true, we get true. So if you want to continue with the same example, we ask if all N in I like to eat apple and bananas for N in fruits, then we get false. But we can change this and add the lemon, and then we get true, because apple, lemon, and banana is in this sentence here. So yeah, to recap, we have the word in, the keyword any, and the keyword all, and these can be very helpful when, yeah, using strings and lists and sets and so on. The second thing I want to discuss today are the magic variables args and quarks. So they are written like this. And the name is not so important. More important are the little stars, so one star or two stars. And yeah, we'll start with args. So args is for non-keyworded variable length argument lists. And yeah, it's basically both args and quarks are basically used in functions, so to define functions. And it's maybe better to understand if I just make an example. So maybe you want to go shopping for food and you want to make a shopping list, and there's some food, so a string input, and yeah, then we just define the function we want to have. So print we need And then the food. And we can try out this with bread. And then, yeah, it just prints out, we need bread. Okay, now maybe we want to add some strings like bananas. And then we get a problem because the function shopping list takes one argument, but two were given. So we have a second argument. So yeah, okay, what could we do? We could add food too. And just copy this. And we would get this result. Okay, but that's not a very good solution because we want this shopping list working for as many arguments as we want. And therefore, the arcs are coming handy. So we just use the star and some more food. So the arc is now more food. Python recognized this via this star. And yeah, then we print the first food item and for e in more food. We can print we also need e. And then we get we need bread, we also need bananas. And yeah, here it looked like there are two input options, but we actually could add as many things as we want. And this definition of this shopping list function still works great. And yeah, it works also great if you just remove all the things and just have nothing for the args argument. So this args argument is optional and we can put as many arguments as we want to. And of course it's also possible to just have this args argument and no like usual input. Therefore I just do a second example. We write a function which adds numbers. Maybe it's a silly task because there are built-in functions which do exactly this, but yeah, just do it as an example. Okay, so the sum is first 0, and for every n in this args value num, we just add the value to the existing sum. And now we can just add numbers. And we get a sum. And this works also fine if we just have one number or many, many numbers. Maybe one thing I'm thinking about in the moment, we sometimes used here plus, but yeah, that's the same as this colon here. Okay, but I said these args are for non-keyworded inputs. So keyworded variables are, for example, lists or dictionaries. So they have keywords. For lists, are the keywords are the entry number. So if we have a list, we can search for the item number 4, for example. And yeah, you know how it works with dictionaries. They also have keys. So these args with one star are for non-keyworded items. And for keyworded items, we use the quarks. So K, V is for keyword arguments, and this stands for arguments. Let's do an example. We had this alfdict. And this alfdict is a keyworded item. And we can write a function intro for introduction and then get some data. And for every key and value in data items, we print my is value. And we can try this out with our dictionary. And then it writes, my name is Gordon Shumway, my nickname is Alf, my year of birth, and so on. The next things I want to introduce are lambda functions and maps. Yeah, so let's do an example. Maybe you have some temperature values in Celsius in a list, and a function Fahrenheit, which takes a value and a temperature in Celsius, and just give out the value in Fahrenheit. So if we if you want to know the value of the Fahrenheit, and we have just 30 degrees Celsius, then we can just use this function. So it takes a number, and now we can use the function map to map the function Fahrenheit to the list temperature. It's important to define all the variables. Okay, and out of this information, T, this is a map object, we can do a list with the function list. And then we have the list ready. So basically the function map maps a function to some object, for example a list. Another way to do this is to use a small anonymous function. So t is map of lambda x, and the floating number of 9, or we just use 9.0, divided by 5, times x plus 34, and then temperature. So here we have a lambda function. This function has no name, so we just use the keyword lambda, and for x, x is the input and this is the output. So this is the lambda function. And we use then the map to map this lambda function to the temperature list. And then again, t is a map object, so if we want to have a list, we can just use the list function. And then t is a list. Okay, so basically we learned how to use a map. So a map uses a function and some variables. And a lambda function is a function without a name. You just write lambda x, and then the colon, and some expression using x. This can be useful if you just have little functions like in this example. So yeah, this is a lot longer than this line here, so sometimes it's useful. The last thing I want to discuss today are exceptions. So exceptions are very useful things when writing long codes, and there could be various errors which might occur or not occur. And yeah, we use the keyword try, and then the test block follows. So for example, we want to print x, then we write except, for example, name error, and we can define something. So this except initiates the block which handles the error, for example, print x is not defined. And then we can also have a finally block, print this is the end of the code. Okay, so for example, in your code sometimes it's very complicated and sometimes x is defined and sometimes not. And to test this, you can write this exception, and if you get the name error, so if x is not defined, it would be the code would print out x is not defined, but which is more important, regardless of the result of the first two blocks here, the finally code here will still run. So here we wanted to print x, and if we just run this one line here, we get the error the name arrow, name X is not defined, but in this whole block, we accept the name arrow and print out X is not defined, but we get to the end of the code. Without this exception, if we would just have print X and then print this is the end of the code, and we would run this, we would not get this last line because we did not accept the name arrow. So in this case, the code would stop here with this arrow and would not run. But here, we try to print X, but we, in case X is not like defined, we would just go here and then continue as usual. Of course, this is also not a problem if X is defined, then we just print X, everything is fine, we skip this accept name arrow block and end here. Yeah, maybe in your short codes, in the moment it's not as a big deal, but there will be some projects coming and I will explain this now. Because the homework of today is for those of you who need a mark for this course, so some of you just want to have the Studienleistung, so the 3 credit points, but they don't need a mark. If you do need a mark, please prepare this homework here because it's about your talk. So yeah, the idea is to find a question or tasks where you could train and use your new Python skills. And maybe you are writing a bachelor thesis or master thesis where you just want to solve a part with Python. And yeah, think about these following questions and write the answers down. And yeah, write down how the program should look like and what it could do. And yeah, please don't aim the project too big or too complicated. It should be solved by you in 3 working hours, so not that much work. And yeah, upload your file as usual to Studapi, and yeah, please do this homework only if you need the mark, not if you just need the credit points, because otherwise I would have to look at nearly 100 ideas, I think, so many students signed up in this StudIP course. Okay, so just think about this and then we can talk about your ideas, and some of you already wrote me an email. Thank you for all your ideas, and I'm looking forward to all your creative input. So yeah, you can upload your ideas or the answers to this homework as Python document, but also as a usual text document. Yeah, just or a PDF, I don't know. Okay, so yeah, let's see you next week. Bye!